Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video we will learn about what is RMS and the average value for the AC signal, or in general we will see what is RMS and the average value for any time varying signal. Now many of you might be already knowing about this RMS and the average value, but in this video we will learn about this RMS and the average value in a different perspective. So let us first of all understand what do we mean by this RMS value. Now if you see most of the instruments which is being used for the measurement, they used to measure this AC voltage and current in terms of this RMS value. And not only that, the voltage signal which is being received at our home, that is a 240 volt 50 hertz signal, this signal also represented in terms of this RMS value. So now the question is, why this AC voltage and the current signals are generally represented in a RMS values? So this RMS value is basically related to the amount of heat which is being produced in particular circuit. So let us say we have one DC voltage source which is having a value of V volt is connected to one particular resistor R, and because of that the DC current I is flowing through that circuit. So we can say that the power that is being dissipated across this resistor R will be I square into R, or we can say that the amount of heat which is being generated because of this power dissipation will be I square into RT. Now suppose if we replace this voltage source by a AC voltage source, then this RMS value represents the effective value of this AC voltage source which will produce the same amount of heat across this particular resistor R. So now suppose we have a DC voltage source of a 20 volt or a AC voltage source which is having a RMS value of a 20 volt, both will produce the same amount of heat across this particular resistor R. And not only the AC signals, but any time varying signal which is having a RMS value of a 20 volt will produce the same amount of heat across that particular resistor R. So even if we have a triangular wave with a 20 volt RMS value, or any arbitrary wave which is having a RMS value of a 20 volt will produce the same amount of heat across that particular resistor R. So in this way, by representing any time varying signal in RMS form, we can directly correlate that signal with the equivalent value of a DC voltage source. So now the question is, how to find the RMS value for the any given particular time varying signal. So let us say we have one time varying signal, that is I of t, which is being varying from time 0 to capital time t. So let us find the RMS value of this particular given signal. So first of all, let us divide this signal in a n number of equal parts. So here each part will have a time period of t over n, as we have divided this signal into the n number of equal parts. And let us say I1, I2 up to IN represents the average value of that particular portion. So now the heat that is being generated by that particular average current I1 will be I1 square into R into t divided by n, provided this signal is connected to one resistor R. Similarly, the heat that is generated by this average current I2 will be I2 square into R into t over n. Likewise, we can say that the heat that is generated by this current IN will be IN square into R into t over n. So we can say that the total amount of heat that is being generated will be I1 square plus I2 square up to IN square divided by n into R into t. Now earlier we had seen that the amount of heat that is being dissipated by this current can also be represented in a RMS form, that is W is equal to IRMS square into R into t. So now if we compare these two equations, then we can write IRMS square, that is equal to I1 square plus I2 square up to IN square divided by n. Now if you see this term is nothing but mean value of this I square. So now as we increase the value of this n, we will get more accurate value of this RMS current, and as n tends to infinity, we can represent this summation in form of the integration. So the mean value of this I square will be 1 over t integration 0 to t into I square t dt. So this represents the mean value of the I square t. So IRMS will be nothing but square root of this mean value, that is 1 over t integration 0 to t into I square t dt. Similarly, we can say that VRMS is equal to under root 1 over t integration 0 to t V square t dt. So in this way, we can find the RMS value of any time varying signal. So now let us find the RMS value of this given AC signal, that is V of t, that is equal to Vm sin omega t. So earlier we had seen that VRMS is equal to under root 1 over t integration 0 to t into V square t dt, or we can write it as a VRMS square, that is equal to 1 over t integration 0 to t into Vm square sin square omega t dt. That is nothing but Vm square into t into integration 0 to t. Now we can write this sin square omega t as 1 minus cos of 2 omega t divided by 2. So now if we integrate this term, then we will get Vm square over 2t into t minus sin of 2 omega t divided by 2 omega with having a limit of 0 to t. So now if you put these limits, then we will get Vm square divided by 2t into t minus sin of 2 omega t divided by 2 omega. Because if you put the value of 0 in this equation, then both the terms will get 0. Now here omega is nothing but 2 pi divided by t, that is equal to 2 pi into f. So we can say that 2 omega t is nothing but 4 pi, and sine of 4 pi will be 0. So this term will get 0. So now we will get VRMS square as Vm square into 2t into t, that is nothing but Vm square divided by 2. Or we can say that VRMS value, that is equal to Vm over root 2. So in this way, for a sinusoidal signal, the RMS value will be Vm over root 2. So now this RMS value does not depend upon the phase of the given AC signal. So suppose if we have a signal V of t that is equal to Vm sin omega t plus 5, then suppose if we find the RMS value for the given signal, then we will get the same value. Similarly, now let us find the RMS value for the full wave rectifier circuit. So now if you know little bit about this full wave rectifier circuit, which is being used for converting the AC signal into the DC signal, then if you see the waveform of this full wave rectifier, it will look like this. So in case of a full wave rectifier, this lower portion of this sine wave will be converted into the positive portion. So we can write this full wave rectifier equation as V of t, that is equal to Vm sin omega t for the period of 0 to capital T by 2. So now for the full wave rectifier, the time period will be equal to half, or we can say that for the full wave rectifier circuit, the frequency of the signal will get doubled. So now let us find the RMS value for this full wave rectifier waveform. So VRMS will be, or VRMS square will be equal to 1 over t integration 0 to t V square t into dt. Now here our time period is t by 2. So we will consider this time period as t by 2. So we will get VRMS square, that is equal to 1 over t by 2, which is having an integration from 0 to t by 2, and the value of V square t will be Vm square sin square omega t into dt. So we will get 2 Vm square divided by t into integration 0 to t by 2 into 1 minus cos of 2 omega t divided by 2 into dt. Or we can write it as a Vm square by t integration 0 to t by 2 into 1 minus cos of 2 omega t into dt. So now if we take the integration of this term, then we will get Vm square by t into t minus sine of 2 omega t divided by 2 omega, which is having a limit from 0 to t by 2. So now if you put these limits, then we will get Vm square by t into t by 2. Because here, when we put this 0, then all the two terms will get 0. And if we put this t by 2 into this equation, then we will get sine of omega t. That is nothing but 2 pi. So this sine of 2 pi will be equal to 0. So in this way, eventually we will get Vm square by 2. Or we can say that Vrms is equal to Vm over root 2. So in this way, for the full wave rectifier waveform also, we have got the RMS value as Vm over root 2. So similarly, you can try to find the RMS value for the case of a half wave rectifier waveform. So now, as we have seen, what is RMS value and why the signals are represented in RMS form, now let us understand about this average value. So as I said earlier, this average value of AC signal is nothing but taking the average value of all the instantaneous values over a particular time period. So for this given particular signal, the average value V average will be nothing but 1 over t integration 0 to t into V of t dt. So by taking the average of all the instantaneous values in the given signal over a particular time, we can find the average value. So similarly, now let us find the RMS value for the given AC signal, that is V of t, that is equal to Vm sine omega t. Now if you see here, if you have a AC signal which is a symmetric about this horizontal axis, then if you find the average value over a particular time period, then you will get average value as a 0. So whenever you have a symmetrical signal, then you can find the average value for the only half period, that is t by 2. So suppose if you want to find the RMS value for this AC signal, then we will consider only the half time period. So the average value for this sinusoidal signal will be equal to 1 divided by t by 2, which is having an integration form 0 to t by 2 into Vm sine omega t into dt. That is equal to 2 Vm by t. And if you take the integration of sine omega t, will be equal to minus cos of omega t divided by omega with the limits from 0 to t by 2. So we will get V average as 2 Vm divided by omega t minus cos of omega t by 2 plus cos of 0. Now if you know, this omega t by 2 is nothing but pi. So we will get 2 Vm divided by 2 pi minus cos of pi plus cos of 0. That is equal to 2 Vm by 2 pi into 2. So in this way, we will get average value as 2 Vm by pi. So the average value for this sinusoidal signal will be equal to 2 Vm by pi. Similarly, now let us find the average value for this half wave rectifier waveform. And as this signal is non-symmetric, so we will find the average value over the entire time period. So the V average will be equal to 1 by t integration 0 to t Vt into dt. That is equal to 1 by t 0 to t by 2 Vm sine omega t dt plus 1 by t integration t by 2 to capital 2. And in this time period, the value of the signal is 0. So we will get 1 by t integration 0 to t by 2 Vm sine of omega t into dt. And if we further simplify it, then we will get Vm by t into minus cos of omega t divided by omega for the time period of 0 to t by 2. And if we further simplify it, then we will get Vm divided by omega t into minus cos of pi plus cos of 0. So that is nothing but Vm divided by 2 pi into 2. So in this way, we have got the average value for the half wave rectifier as Vm divided by pi. Similarly, you can try to find the average value for the full wave rectifier waveform. So now, as we know about this RMS and the average values, now let us see the two more definitions, that is form factor and the peak factor, which are related to this RMS and the average values. So first, let us see the form factor, that is the ratio of this RMS and the average value. And second is the peak factor. So this peak factor is the ratio of the peak value of the signal divided by the RMS value. So I hope in this video you understood about this, what is RMS and the average value for the AC signal, or in general for any time varying signal, and what is form factor and the peak factor for the AC signals. So if you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.